Boyd Coddington was an American hot rod builder. His designs and builds really made a statement in the hot rod world. Boyd built cars for many celebrities, including ZZ Top and the Beach Boys. He was also the host of the hit TV show American Hot Rod.
It's the man of the hour.
Sadly, Boyd died unexpectedly in 2008. Boyd helped jumpstart many careers, including designer Chip Foose and fabricator Jesse James. Charley Hutton worked as Boyd's painter for many years before opening his own shop in Nampa, Idaho. My client hired Charley Hutton to update the cars. They're here at Charley's shop, and I'm going to see him today.
This must be Charley's place.
So Charley, boy, this thing looks absolutely gorgeous. The paint is superb.
Well, thank you. For me, you know, the dream was to always build hot rods. And of course, growing up, Boyd was my idol. You know, as a kid thumbing through the magazines, it was always the Boyd cars that got my attention.
Hey, Boyd, rumor had it the other day that...
And how Boyd and I got together is Boyd had built a 33 Roadster for Michael Anthony, the bassist for Van Halen. Well, we had a customer out of Fallbrook, California, that we built a 33 three-window coupe for that was basically the sister car to that. And Boyd had seen it, and next thing you know, I get a phone call from him. And as they say, the rest is history.
Boyd had a certain look to his cars.
The big thing with Boyd was the stance, you know, and the good, clean, simple lines. Boyd, he basically created rolling art. You know, instead of that hot rod race car theme that a lot of cars, you know, in the earlier generations were built, he gave it that new flavor, the more elegance. He created the billet wheel, cleaned up the lines, removed door handles, basically made them elegant cars rather than that racy feel of a car.
I've come to take a look at two Chevrolets and a Ford pickup truck. A 1950 Chevrolet Fleetline Fastback.
It was originally done for a gentleman by the name of Jamie Musselman. Mm-hmm. Then Jamie had sold it to somebody, and then, of course, our customer, Bill O'Brien, purchased it from them. And after he had purchased the car, he had originally made contact with Boyd to, you know, get it into Boyd's shop to have it redone.
Right.
Well, about that time is when, you know, Boyd Coddington had gotten sick, unfortunately had passed away. And so then the owner had contacted us to, you know, take that role that Boyd was going to take in redoing the car.
Your door fits are just absolutely gorgeous.
Well, we tried to pride ourselves on the fit and finish. You know, I always joke that, you know, you can train a monkey to paint, but it's the detail before and the detail after. Yeah. You know, and fit and finish is so critical, so crucial.
It is.
We did put a new motor in it. In the sedan, it's running a 350 with dual four-barrel carburetors, so. Tranny was completely gone through, rebuilt. Car, when it was originally built, had drum brakes. We put disc brakes on it. Other than that, it's pretty much the way Boyd had built it. It's just fresh. And the point for us was to try to retain that original flavor that Boyd had given the car when he'd originally built it.
So we've got the Fastback, but the convertible really looks great. It's a 1949 Chevrolet convertible. Now, Boyd did this about the same time as the Fastback?
Yeah, this one actually was built after the Fastback. The only changes we did to it is we did the same gas filler treatment. And on this one, with the bumpers, originally it had the bumper bolts. So we smoothed the bumpers so it had the same look as the 50 sedan.
And this has got what for power?
What this has is an LT1.
Yeah, that's nice and clean. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, clean and simple. This is one of the first LT1s Boyd had put in a car, and he did not build an engine cover for it. And then in the later years, he used to build the engine covers for him, so that's what we decided what we would do is build a cover just like the ones that Boyd used to build.
Convertible top, power?
Yep, convertible top is power. Ron Mangus actually did the neat little, he built a fiberglass cover that covers the top. So you just remove that and then the power top comes up. Everything on the two cars is pretty much identical, other than one's a convertible, one's a sedan.
What my client told me is true. These are two really cool hot rods. It's hard to improve on a Coddington car, but Charlie's refresh is totally flawless, and it's a great tribute to Boyd Coddington. I also think it'll really add value when we bring him to auction. It's go time for the Boyd Coddington cars. First up is the Fleetliner convertible.
Let's see how we do.
Before we get up there, how close do we have to be?
He'll make that decision.
Okay.
You get over 100, I got it.
Don't browbeat him, but just...
No, I won't. I just got to tell the auctioneer where to go.
You get over 100, we got it.
All right, F91, here's a 49 Chevy convertible built by Boyd Coddington. Original Chip Foos concept design, full documentation, LT1350 turbo 300 transmission underneath the hood.
And here we go! How much ammo? Nobody can put it here, 200,000. How much ammo?
Our strategy was to set the reserves high. That way there we could lift the reserve just at the right time to start a bidding war.
The bid's right here at 80,000, now 90. Have a tiny bid, now 90, 100, you're out now 100. Have a tiny bid, upon the buy, upon the buy, 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 now 100. Have a tiny bid, give me $95,000, gotta go, hands in the air, 90, 95. 90 bid, down 5, buy, 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 95,000, buy, buy, 90 bid, down, buy, buy, 95,000. 92,5, 95, you're out, 92,5, buy, 95, buy, down, 10, 5, buy, 95, buy, 95, buy, 95, buy, 95, buy, 95, 97,5, 100, 100, 100, 5,000, 100, 5,000, go. 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105, 105,
and we knew it wouldn't achieve that price. Bill was looking to take home $100,000, so when it hit 105, we lifted the reserve.
Inside, last call, 105. Sold it, 105, sold, 105, 105,000, sold.
The car hammers at $105,000. Everyone's real happy with that price.